Barry wanted me next to him. He wanted me with him all the time. So that made it a little easier for me to make it easier for him.
The first diagnosis of a terminal illness brings a number of thoughts to the minds of the patient's loved ones. Denial. We use denial as a defense mechanism to mask the immediate shock and to distance ourselves from the reality of the situation. Anger. Why did this happen to someone I love? It isn't fair. Bargaining. If only things could go back to the way it used to be. If only we can go back in time. Depression. A feeling of sadness and emptiness begins to sneak through. Acceptance. We are ready to try and move on, but we will never forget. These are the five stages of grief. The survivors left behind have all experienced them during their hard times.
We met in California because we were both there on business. We were in allied fields, and we met in California. And what a beautiful place to meet. Yeah, we had a blessed life. We traveled, and we went to the fanciest restaurants, and we just lived a wonderful life together. So it would be hard for me to pick out one memory. I guess maybe from when we first met, that was a great memory.
唯一一次就是有一天一个周末他不忙，然后他跟我妈两个人带我去北京一个朝阳公园，公园里面有个篮球场，但是我不记得我多大了，然后我就去打篮球，然后他跟我妈两个人呢就站在旁边看着我打球。我记得是个周日，然后阳光明媚啊，那也就是在我记忆里面唯一一次我们一家人就是在平常周末的时候一块出去玩。
Fear. A distressing emotion aroused by impending danger, or something that causes feelings of dread. It can happen any day, and when you least expect it. But it will be a day you will always remember.
My name's Rose Hausman. I have stage 4 colorectal cancer. I was diagnosed in November of 2005. Initially, I could not believe it. I thought I was going to die very soon. When my family first found out, my children, I was in the hospital, I told them to come in. I told them, I am going to be positive about this, and we're going to beat this, and you're going to beat it with me.
So there's Barry. That's my favorite. That's our wedding picture. Prior to our being married, when we were engaged, he had open heart surgery, and he had been ill before that, so there was never one particular day when I noticed that he was ill. It was something that evolved over many years.
一直他那个周末他们一直不在家，不在家，那也没人管我，我就自己在玩电脑。然后等到周一的时候，我记得特别清楚，那天在下雨，是个阴天。早上七点多天还特别黑，然后呢我爸也不在家，然后我妈吃早饭的时候就告诉我说你爸得了肠癌，而且是晚期。那个时候我上初二，但是我对这个病没有什么概念，但是我知道这是什么东西，我也知道这个很严重，所以我不记得我怎么到的学校，但是我记得那天早上上第一节语文课的时候我就一直在哭，我就一直在哭。
I've had a multitude of surgeries. many surgeries, and it does get you down. I don't like to lay around. I've never been a person to lay around, so it is very hard and difficult to deal with that when you have to. But when I get back up, I come back strong.
Well, he was a tough Brooklyn guy. For somebody who was as physical as he was all his life, he ran marathons. He played tennis every night of his life. He jogged every single morning before he left for work. Whether it was icy or pouring down rain, he went out for his run every morning. And so it was very hard on him, I think, although I never heard him complain or say anything negative.
然后呢，在这之前呢，他一直生病，大概有三年左右，但是在他生病之前呢，就是他一直特别努力的工作。然后他周末的时候经常要加班，所以我其实没有太多时间可以看见他。然后每天晚上吃饭的时候，基本上就是我跟我妈两个人。就算她回来了也是很晚，然后也知道就是应酬嘛。然后回来以后，就是一般我在我印象里，她每次回来就是在吐，在吐，吐得很厉害。对，所以周末呢，因为加班也没有什么时间。家里人一块出去玩，关系嘛，不能说特别亲，但是也没有很疏远。
Challenge. Something that by its nature or character serves as a call to action. Obstacles are inevitable, but it's up to each individual to overcome daily struggles.
At this stage of life, to start over so far away from anything I know, it would have been very, very tough.
My everyday challenges with stage 4 colon cancer right now are keeping a good attitude. I'm waiting to get in a clinical trial. My chemotherapy stopped working, so I try to stay positive. I have a colostomy and a urostomy bag, my rectum and bladder removed.So I have to deal with keeping them in check because it can become very difficult to maintain them. I'm constantly babysitting them. Anyway, but my biggest challenge is just to stay positive, which along with the help of a lot of people, I'm able to do pretty well.
Well, Barry had so much wrong with him. I don't even know where to begin. No, really. But he became seriously ill. It's 3 years now. He was ill, really seriously ill for 2 years, the last 2 years of his life. In addition to that, he had Parkinson's. First symptom you notice is a tremor in the hands. And then your gait changes. And then the facial muscles kind of freeze so that your expression is not...flexible. I didn't even notice that until I accompanied him to his first neurologist. But she pointed it out to me that if you'll notice, you know, when I ask you something, your facial expressions change. But if you notice that Barry's face doesn't change when, and son of a gun, like, I didn't notice that. And thatphysical disability was really what led to his eventual decline.
Family, a close or cherished relation with loved ones. Families undergo many challenges, but through all, when times get tough, they will always be there for one another.
My brother and his wife, and here's my son and us together.
I have 10 siblings. They have surrounded me with love, attention, and compassion from the beginning. I've been embraced by my community and so many people. And my family, together, we stand strong with all our support. I'm really blessed in that way. My family is very supportive of me. They've been, my husband is my caretaker. Anytime I'm in the hospital, he's there. He talks to doctors. He does everything. When I couldn't care for myself for 3 months, he changed my bags. He did everything for me. So as far as my husband, he is amazing. He's amazing. And my children, my oldest son was mentally ill when he found out. He has since passed away. He took it pretty rough.
He said that the reason that he stayed married to me for so many years was because I made him laugh every day. And so I tried to cheer him up, and he was receptive. It wasn't like he's, you know, like, don't annoy me or anything. He wanted that part of our lives to continue. I always had him, like, propped up in bed with the pillows and everything. And there was a cartoon called The Little King. And that's what they called him, because I would run up and down the steps with his food, you know, and have all the pillows. And so they said he was the little king. But that was okay.
我进到医院里以后呢，我就看到他躺在床上，然后他已经不能呼吸了，他身上接的呼吸机，他看见我进来了，然后他就握着我的手，张着嘴想说话，但是什么也说不出来了，然后我就看到他的眼泪从眼睛里流出来，然后眼珠从黑色变成灰色，那个时候我就觉得就是那种悔恨的心情就是已经抑制不住了，然后这件事情我觉得我这辈子都不会原谅自己。
Distress, extreme anxiety, sorrow, or pain. Hope is lost and the world crumbles. One can only brace themselves for the worst.
可能会焦急，可能会紧张，可能会恐惧，但是我觉得除了到最后一刻为止，在过程中应该是不会有痛苦的这种感觉的，因为毕竟是自己最爱的人，所以肯定要竭尽全力去，不管这是什么吧，竭尽全力去战胜它。但是当最终失败的时候呢，那种无助、痛苦、后悔，就是形容不出来的，需要。
Towards the end, it was very, very tough. He fell, he was very weak, and it was very hard to watch. Because you don't know what else to do. There really isn't anything to do, but you don't want to acknowledge that because you think, you know, maybe there is something you can do, but then it turns out not.The hardest thing was seeing him deteriorate. That was very, very difficult.
Had this picture taken.
Composure. The state or feeling of being calm and in control of oneself. Acknowledging the situation while holding on to those very last memories.Realizing that after all, they will always remain in one's life.
我需要肩负起一个男人的责任。当时我听到这个话的时候呢，我并没有太多的感觉。但是在他过世了的时候呢，这是唯一的一句话留在我脑海里边的。我可以说，直到今天为止这句话一直影响着我，作为我人生的信条吧，或者是一种准则，然后在做事情的时候要 去肩负这个责任。如果这个事情是我必须做的话，我不会找任何借口，一定要把它做成。
I'm sure you've had this experience. If the phone rings and nobody's on the other end of the line, he's, hello, and, oh, it must be Barry because he called so many times during the day and that's just a wish, you know. So many things that it could be a particular smell of something that he liked to eat or just...friends, you know, thinking about things that we do. Oh, I think about them all the time. I miss them.
If my son Justin was here today, he would just hug me and hug me. I feel him with me every day. And I know that he lifts me. He is with me. I know he is proud of me. He encourages me. He's my angel.